2022. What can I say about it? Well, in terms of animated films, since it's the main topic, I say we have a pretty good year. Even much better than last year. Like, if you recall, like, from my last review, in terms of theatrically released animated films, I only have a number of 7. But for this year, there are much more, like 8 of them, where there are many of those I much prefer than others this current year. Now, before I get started, I have some disclaiming information to put out. Well, this year was a return to more stop-motion animated films like Wendell Wild by Henry Selick and Pinocchio by Guillermo del Toro. The only catch is that they're released on Netflix as well as the others, which I won't mention, but say that they will not be included on this list or any honorable mentions. So I'm sorry to put that out. And finally, as for the other anime films released on other streaming platforms like Amazon Prime, Hotel Transylvania, Transformania, or Apple Plus's Luck, they won't be on this list since part of the reason that I don't have those streaming services on my television network. So I'm sorry to put that. Anyway, let's start off with the bottom 4. Starting at number 8 is Paws of Fury, The Legend of Hank. Personally, I don't see the point of watching that film again due to, like, having strong similarities between two Kung Fu Panda movies, the first and the second combined without anything original. And it's sad to say that it's by the director or co-director of The Lion King and Mr. Peabody Sherman, Rob Minkoff. But on the bright side, I'm very pleased that he was able to make that film into fruition after being delayed for 5 years. But that doesn't say much for everything about it just being down mediocre at worst. From the stories, to the characters, to the decent animation, which probably won't save this film. So, not much. Moving on. Number 7 is Lightyear. Now, this was supposed to be the grand return of Pixar on the big screen after putting most of their anime films on Disney Plus, including, as mentioned, Soul, Luca, and Turning Red. Well, I say it's just fine, not much. Though it was very different from all the 4 Toy Story films released. This film explores a much more emotional side to Buzz Lightyear's story, who is voiced by Chris Evans and his other crew, and how they became the action figures they are to Andy. And from it, I almost found it forgettable at best. But there were some elements about it, like with the animation being very different, like having a muted color palette instead of the brightly colored the 4 original films have. So I guess that's something worthy of praise. And Chris Evans on the voices, as well as the others, they did pretty fine at best, including Sock's voice by Peter Song. If you want something out of this world, then you can enjoy this film if you can. Number 6 is the Bob's Burgers movie. As unfamiliar to the show, I had to watch a couple or several episodes to learn the essentials, and after watching that and the movie, it was pretty interesting. And fun fact, like, this the first time an anime film based on cartoon aimed at old audiences has been made since 1999 South Park Bigger, Longer, and Uncut. And the songs might be one of the best things about this film because they're much more tamer and less raunchy than the ones in that film. While it knocked me on the ranks as something like with The Simpsons, I say it's a fine film on its own, and I can say it's pretty much underrated. Also, the animation, while it has strong similarities to Simpsons, it's pretty good at best. Not great, but good, with major upgrades. Along with the story having a crime twisted, that's executed very nicely. Give the Bob's Burgers movie and the Belchers the attention it deserves, please. Number 5, DC League of Super Pets. Now, I prefer this over my bottom 3 mentioned previously because from it, it was like Warner Animation's answer to the duology of Illumination Secret Life of Pets films with a superhero twist to it. And from it, I found it more enjoyable than the rest because I have a strong love for dogs. In terms of DC League of Super Pets, while the action would make this pet-centric anime film much more exciting, I much prefer Illumination's Pets duology because it has a much more vibrant color palette on its own and a more jazzy tune to it, while this film is more flashy and more orchestral. But I will give this film credit for having a good voice cast, even though they're celebrities. Dwayne Johnson still being his hard-headed self, and Kevin Hart giving a much more tame performance than voicing that maniacal white bunny Snowball. So if you want to see what this is all about, I recommend it. Moving on to my top 4, prefer others, I have on number 4, Strange World. While this film will go down history as another one of Disney Animation's failed attempt of an adventure film after the hand-drawn Atlantis, Lost Empire, and Treasure Planet, I see it has a much beautiful animation with the underworld having a much vibrant color with all the pinks, reds, oranges, and yellows, and all that stuff compared to the earthy green or blue colors. The characters might get off on the wrong foot and would lead to a predictable misunderstanding and resolution. The most two standout characters that would make this film much more enjoyable are the dog Legend and the faceless blue alien Splat. It's a good watch for it, even though you have to get through all that drama. So go ahead. Number 3, I have Minions: The Rise of Gru. I prefer this over Strange World because compared to that film, which had an adventurous tone, the Minions sequel has a much more funny tone. And while the jokes may be the same juvenile Minion shenanigans, this improves on its 2015 predecessor. And like with its slapstick comedy and taking the Minions to a different locales, along with a team of retro villains that can and spice up its tone with its 90s, 70s style compared to the predecessor's 1960s. If you want something more groovy, then check this one out if you're a Minions fan or even a Despicable Me fan of the franchise. Number 2 is DreamWorks The Bad Guys. Compared to last year's, where Spirit Untamed was like the first animated film DreamWorks released on the big screen since Abominable, this one was much more thrilling to watch because like, while it might have the same structure, like, either from Despicable Me, Wreck-It Ralph, or Megamind, in terms of bad guys turning good, along with its premise of animals in the big city with Zootopia, Sing, or Rock Dog, the action sequences are really what will get you intrigued in this film, along with its solid cast of characters and the stylized animation inspired by Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, which gives the film a much more painterly look instead of just replicating the style. And that's something that's admirable, seeing DreamWorks Animation improving from last year and going in a brand new direction with this film. Speaking of DreamWorks, Pray for Mercy from the number one anime film released theatrically of 2022 is Puss in Boots: The Last Wish. Well, what can I say about it? Out of all the mediocre anime sequels DreamWorks have put out, either from The Croods, The Trolls, or The Boss Baby, this one was a massive improvement and probably one of the best sequels we ever had and since Shrek 2. Personally, Puss in Boots: The Last Wish might be the best thing to come out from the Big Green Ogres franchise since that 2004 sequel. And my biggest regret is not giving Puss in Boots as much praise as I done in my previous 8 out of 10 review. It would definitely boost it up a bit. But back onto my thoughts. Puss in Boots sequel was just amazing. Like, starting off with the voice cast, Antonio Banderas and Selma Hayek, they are still top-notch with their voices of Puss and Kitty Softballs, respectively, along with some amazing action sequences. Instead of the chase sequences, we got loads of fight sequences between three pairs of villains that would almost seem like an issue of Shrek the Third, where it has too many villains, but they really help you spice up this film much more, their fights and thrills, compared to what Jack and Jill did in the 2011 predecessor. Boy, did I love this film very much. And while I said initially it might not have the emotional depth of the first Shrek 2 movies, I would digress. I'll say again that comparing this along with the Shrek 2 sequel, along with Kung Fu Panda 2 or How to Train Your Dragon 2, this can also be up there in the ranks between the middle or even better. There's a lot more heart and more depth to the premise and the characters that will make you want to follow them the whole way through. That's why Puss in Boots: The Last Sequel definitely deserves to be on this top list. It seems like this, along with The Bad Guys, showcases that DreamWorks Animation can really get better from there. So I wish them the best of luck. Before I close this off, I'd like to tell you about a few changes on my reviews. First off, the format. Format will have an opening logo to my review, John Bell Reviews, along with my new outfit to put my game face on. And along with the ratings, I'm gonna add three new ones: 7.5, 8.5, and 9.5. Since Animat Matt Brunette was a huge inspiration to help me really up my game for the future of 2023. So stay tuned for these changes, and let's see what next year has to offer.